Welcome back, everybody. With the introductions having taken place, we are ready to go. The skills competition pits the players on the Western Conference side against those on the Eastern Conference team. There are six events involved in the skills competition that you're about to see here at the Fleet Center tonight. Here's what they look like. When this is the order they will be in. Puck control, the fastest skater, and there are some fast ones. The hardest shot, we got a special treat coming up for you on that one. The rapid fire, the accuracy that Ray Bourque wants so badly, and the breakaway that'll involve virtually everybody.
And it's going to be a whole lot of fun with that. And the players are going to have to settle the puck down and make the good passes whenever they're doing the puck control relay. What I obviously love, Gary, is the fact that it's one-on-one competition between the players and the goaltenders. And this is something that you obviously have to really get yourself geared up, because right now it's a relaxing moment. And now they've got to get themselves ready for this. Here it is. The goalie competition. Goaltender with the most saves after the rapid fire and the breakaway relay is the winner. The defending champs in the rapid fire, John Van Beesbrick and Arthur Irbay, and for the breakaway, Curtis Joseph. But overall, John Van Beesbrick and Patrick Waugh tied in 1984 at Madison Square Garden with 12 saves each.
So you have a couple of competitions going on at once here. There's Felix Potvin. You have the East against the West overall for the whole competition, and you have the goaltenders going against the shooters.
Love it.
You
fans love
it, don't you?
Love that stuff.
Want to remind you, coming up, National Hockey Night, Jeremy Roenick, Eric Lindros, Legion of Doom, MVP last year, Jaromir Jagr. All these folks are going to be involved every Sunday night in February in games you'll be seeing on National Hockey Night. Sunday nights during the month of February, with a race for the playoffs underway. Blackhawks and Ducks on the 4th, the Avalanche and the Flyers. Stanley Cup Final, maybe, on the 11th. Rangers and Penguins on the 18th. The battle may be in the East in the end. The Blackhawks and the Flyers, maybe another Stanley Cup matchup on the 25th. Every Sunday in February, 8 o'clock Eastern, great games. Our first skills competition is the puck control relay, and it is run as a relay. Players are going through right now. These are the rules. There are two races involved. One's a relay, one's a solo. There'll be three skaters involved in each of the team competition, and then one separate. Take a look at how it works. Here's the map. They got to pick the puck up, come down, length of the ice, get it, go through the cones. They must have control of the puck all the way till they get to the other end. They cannot lose control. They have to go back to get it. That went faster than even they do.
It's a heck of a lot easier up here looking at that. But you can see how difficult it is to maneuver around the pylons. And it's sort of, you've got to cup the puck and make sure you take it with a lot of control. You can't be reckless because you'll lose control of the puck.
The Western Conference teams will be starting first in the competition. See, the pucks are set up. And there you see the cones that they've got to go through. Joe Sakic racing on the western side of it. There is Sakic. Pierre Turgeon racing on the east. Now remember, this is a relay, so when they get up to the other end, as soon as they cross the line, and they must cross the line entirely with the puck, that's when the next in line takes off. Wayne Gretzky on the western side. Peter Bondra will come back to pick the puck up. There's the great one. Gretzky, fourth in the league in scoring, going into this all-star break, handling it up the other way against Peter Bondra of Washington. Last year, 34 goals in 47 games for Bondra, who got ahead of that one. Now here's the leg. Brian Leetch and Paul Coffey, two of the greatest defensemen the game's ever seen.
Two of the great skaters as well. I thought Wayne Gretzky did a great job against Peter Bondra. He's a speedster. Good battle here between Leetch and Coffey.
Leetch lost the puck. Brian Leetch on the other side for a moment. Paul Coffey with those wheels goes in ahead, and those are the three. With, it looks like, the Western Conference ahead on that one. Brian Leetch had trouble handling that. You get one goal here for the winner, and the West did win it. So they take the 1-0 lead based on the relay. There's Paul Coffey, who was on that final leg.
And I was interested to see how he handled that, because he's got a sore thumb, but he really handled the puck well. Seemed to not bother him at all, Gary.
Now, this is the solo. Matt Sundin will go against Pierre Turgeon. Turgeon actually racing twice here, as Jaromir Jagr was going to go in his place, but could not. So Turgeon will race. Now, this is just the two of them, and they go one-on-one in this one. There you see Matt Sundin, his first All-Star appearance, the first European ever drafted number one in the NHL. He's 24th in the league in scoring here at the All-Star break. Pierre Turgeon, looking at a guy right now playing in Montreal, tied for 17th in the league in scoring.
What a great puck handler and setup man he is. But Matt Sundin couldn't skate this morning because of all the difficulties with weather. His gear didn't get here till late this afternoon.
A point up for grabs. A goal goes to the conference whose player wins this one. Sundin's got to go back.
The happy feet.
He's a good horse, though. They can only go on the whistle. Brian Lewis, the director of officials out there doing that. Same thing now. They got to pick the puck up and come back through the cones. Turgeon in white. Over on the other side, Matt Sundin in blue. Who crosses the line first? In control of the puck. Turgeon's got a little lead here, and Turgeon got it. So Turgeon beats Sundin in the one-on-one part of the relay.
No disrespect to Pierre Turgeon, but you'd think when you're thinking Sundin and Turgeon going one-on-one, you'd think Matt Sundin would have the edge. He's a better skater, a faster skater, but obviously Pierre Turgeon's a sly guy, and he's a smooth skater, got to point A to point B in a hurry.
So 1-1 after the puck control relay, and you talk about fast skaters. Well, the fastest skater competition is coming up next, and one of the men who throughout his career has been known as one great set of wheels. There he is, Mike Gartner. When we come back.